Hello everybody, this is a video about how to automate 3D models using Python code and FreeCAD. Now FreeCAD has a utility called freecadcmd. In previous versions, the installer for FreeCAD was your typical Linux, Mac, Windows installer. However, now you can download an image. The image is basically a self-contained file. I know there's been a few people who've been confused about how to actually find the freecadcmd utility now. So what I'm going to do is just show you how to structure the code, and then we'll look at how to run the code. So without further ado, let's go to the next slide. What we're going to be using for reference for our example code is the topological data scripting on the freecadweb.org wiki. And in a nutshell, what you need to do is you need to specify the name of your app image. And all I've done here is I've just renamed it from FreeCAD app image, blah, 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 to just FreeCAD-0.2. And then you type FreeCADCMD. FreeCADCMD, same as it always was. So it basically puts you into a Python shell. And as you see, I just demonstrated it here. Print length, hello world, it gives you 11. So to automate the code, you just run the file as a Python file, but instead of prefixing it with Python or Python 3, you use the name of your app image, followed by freecadcmd, followed by the name of your Python file. Now, your Python file will contain all the code, which we'll look at next. And in your Python file, you just need to specify the name of the output file, and that's the file extension. So you've got a choice of various different ones. I've chosen iges. And to check your work, once you've actually run the code, you can open it in FreeCAD. So I'm just going to exit out of this, and keyboard interrupt, thank you. And then if this is a bit of a mess, I'm afraid, just do clear. And I've tried to compile this from source, but I ran into all sorts of issues because I've got multiple versions of Python installed on my machine and I was getting some CMake build errors. If anybody's interested, then contact me and I'll go into those and what I've tried if it's of interest. So I'm running Linux. If you're running Windows or Mac OS X, then that probably isn't of interest to you in this video. So without further ado, let's actually just look at... what I'll do, before we look at the code, I'll show you where I actually got it from. So the wiki page, which is on here, wiki.freecadweb.org, topological data scripting, part scripting, see also, and Open Cascade. So FreeCAD obviously uses different methods. You can create parts, you can create assemblies, you can create sketches. So for the purpose of this video, we just want to show how you can create a part module directly from the FreeCAD Python interpreter or from any external script. If you want to read more, this is a good place to come, the topological data scripting page. If you want to see any other tips and hints, FreeCAD forum. And Python scripting and macros, and somebody's commented today, so that's good. This means it's regularly contributed to. So let's just look at what did I write earlier. I wrote s1.py really was a very bare minimum. So you import FreeCAD as app, import part, create an instance of the app, and then use the new document method, just creating line here, and then you create an object which contains the line, and then you recompute, and then you create a shape object which you can then export, and that's where you specify your output file name. So that's fairly basic. If you want to see me run that, then let's just run that before we move on to the good code, shall we call it. The autocomplete's not working because I'm being lazy. There we go. FreeCAD CMD. and the name of your Python file. Hopefully it still works. You see the ASCII text, and effectively what's happening is it's firing it up FreeCAD, doing the work and closing it again all seamlessly without involving the GUI. So let's do S2, which is the good file, the one that's containing some pretty impressive stuff. So this is taken from the wiki page, the FreeCAD wiki. So import FreeCAD as up. In fact, I've imported that those two bits twice. Don't know why that did that. Anyway, part math. So there's a function here called make bottle tut. So just standard Python function. Nothing to do with FreeCAD here, really, other than we're using an instance of FreeCAD app. We're creating some vector points, arcs, shapes. I don't know what the app.matrix is, so this is all still relatively new to me. I just wanted to kind of share that you can actually make things from freecadcmd, even using the app image. So it returns something called my body, and then here you just you run the function, and you call it el, and then you do part.show el, and then I don't even know if you need to do the show, but here we go. Here's a good bit: el.exportiges. If you want to use another format, you can do STL and numerous other formats. So I've just done IGS. And that's the line that actually creates your output file. So let's just to prove that there's no trickery going on, I'm just going to remove, I've already got a file too from when I tested it. There we go. So now, FreeCAD 02, so that's the app image name. Then freecadcmd, and then that's the name of your Python file. So run that. Takes a few seconds, 2 or 3 seconds maybe. And then it's recreated here. You see file 2 IGS. And then what we'll do is we'll run freecad. If I run freecad, I'll get an error because I broke it. I broke it when I was trying to install from source. So let's close that. And what we'll do is we'll actually run the app. Here we go. And it's just basically opened up FreeCAD. And what I need to do now is just go to the open dialog box. And let's find. So if the font's a bit small, I'm going to get straight to the IGS file. That's the one I've just created at 15:20, so 1 minute ago. And something's happening. And here we go. That Python code created what looks like a hip flask or a shampoo bottle, who knows, but there we go. So that's actually, close that, saving. That is the IGS file which has successfully opened with FreeCAD. So there we go. And if I just do Control C, box is still open, keeping it open. So there we go. And if you want to know any more, as I say, the main focus of this is actually that you can still use FreeCAD CMD using the app image. So hopefully it's been interesting. I'm not going to waffle on. Please subscribe. The subscribe level on this channel is appalling. So if you want to help, you want to keep the channel going, you want to keep me making semi-useful videos, then subscribe, and we'll see you again soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.